What's going on, everyone? Welcome to Code Shifter. Yes. All right, guys. Hope you guys are having a really great day today. Listen, Code Shifter is an 8-bit crossover game developed. Developed Lanho Co. A. Ltd. and published by Arc System Works as a side-scrolling action platformer video game. Yes. Its initial release date was on January 30th, 2020, and platforms are for Windows, Nintendo Switch, Xbox, and that is as far as I know. That's it. Alright, so Code Shifter, bros, I got it on sale. It was like $2 on the Xbox. Now, I'm right here in the Steam page. And it's mostly a negative. Anyways, yes, let's just get away from all that negativity real quick and, you know, start the game, right? Now, I've read a bunch of comments, I've seen a bunch of videos saying that this game, you know, like it's a letdown or something like that, bro. I mean, oh no. The only thing that's letting me down is all my stuff right now. Okay, so far, so good. Keep going. By the way, I do like the art style, though. It's one of the art, like, this kind of art style is definitely the kind of art style that I was trying to get into, right? Like, at some point, I wanted to make something like this. Never really got into it because I don't know how to do it. 79%, 100%. Yeah, baby, error-free. The Code Shifter is complete. I hope that you're listening to what I'm listening to because I'm listening to gibberish. Time for a little test run. Create your Code Shifter avatar. Okay, I'll call you Sarah. Strap in, girl. We've got a lot of work. Okay, Code Shifter activated. Okay. But yeah, so... is this us? Oh, actually, I know, man. I mean, woo! Oh, okay, there we go. Alright, so... you know, I know about the hate that this game got, right? I mean... I don't... in my opinion, I don't really think it deserves all that, but... you know, Bounty Code Shifter unit. Okay. Bro. What do I do? Oh, stage one. Alright. Debugging. Alright. Mainly because, you know, apparently the devs tricked people into thinking that this is going to be a, you know, like a pixel art game of all the other games. Oh, okay. Mozzie's helping hand next Xbox. Please help me find the bike. Okay. Yeah, I got it, man. All right. So, first and foremost, right? It is very responsive. I mean, I do see a little problem. You know, when she hits the ground, we kind of like move forward. But, you know, that's nothing bad, man. Okay, let's go. Found a bug. Oh, my bad. Alright. Debug it. Nice. But yes, the only thing I don't like about it so far is that I can't move with the D-pad, which I'm used to with every, 2D side-scroller game. Sure, score. Which I can check anytime. Okay, yeah, I got it, man. Let's do this. Oh my gosh! Can we double jump? Yeah, we can. I don't like this, though. I really don't like this. I'm not reading what she's saying, by the way. Because I know how to play a dang platformer game, bro. Oh my god. We can crouch? I don't know. Oh my goodness. That's the one thing. Oh my lord. I don't like how she is like stopping me for every little bit, bro. I know what to do. You send me here to debug some stuff. That's what I'm doing, man. Like let me debug. Let me do this. But anyways, that aside from that, because I know it's probably gonna be a constant theme that, like, you know, I'm gonna get interrupted with with, you know, this. Just one more. No, I don't want to go in. Okay, okay, never mind. Okay, that was just a checkpoint. I mean, maybe if I could have, you know, stopped and listened to what she's saying, you know, I could have known. But that's just me, man. I mean, I'm getting interrupted with every little bit, man. I can't take a breath. Look, just, I this is the finish line. Yes. Okay. All of that, we got something. But anyways, you know, like, I don't know, man. Code Shifter, to me, it sounds like, you know, like something, like something you would see in an office, right? But minus this whole, you know, Battle Network Mega Man thing going on.
Rudy, morning.
Whoa, you don't look so hot. Did you pull an all-nighter? Sure did. I started testing out the latest build and couldn't stop. It's insane. I know how it is once you get into the groove, but you have to. Oh, and get this. Last night I finally got the prototype. All right, everybody. Meeting time. Everybody come to the Greg zone. Whoops. Hold on to that thought. We could be in the meeting. Okay. My headphones are dying, bro. I can tell. Okay, so as I hope you're all aware by now, the game we've been working on, Rainbow Rangers, has made its big media debut, meaning we've got 1 month left to work. I repeat, we go gold in a month, people. I need you all to focus and bring your A game. Seriously, Buggy starts right now. We submitted our last build to the debugging company. So I expect the bug report will start pouring in like mad. You all responsible for quality of this project. Let's make sure it shines. Oh, and one last thing. All this weirdness that has been happening. You mean where the game's code randomly rewrites or deletes itself? That weirdness? Yeah, that. We've all seen it once. At least once. Well, not me. I've seen it all the time. It's actually a huge problem. Are you sure? Are you sure those aren't your mistakes? The point is, someone's getting careless. The rewrites are numerous and they are weird. I'm sure you're all being super careful already. But time being what it is, I want everybody to be extra careful. Now let's go finish the game. By the way, he looks like a douche. Just saying. Greg's telling us to be careful because he still has no idea what's happening, right? That's right. I had data, I know I saved just up and disappeared, and I nearly lost my mind. Half a day's work gone. I'm losing design work, no laughing matter. Nope. So what are you gonna tell me earlier? Alright, wait till you hear this. What the heck is this? Mosey! I swear, bro, figure it out, bro. You're a game designer. Huh? What's wrong, Mosey? All the file names in my folder are total garbage. How did you manage to do that? Another X in the key press? No, I don't touch anything you possess. I bet I know what's going on. It's perfect timing, actually. Rue, listen up. I'm really going to fill you in the story from earlier. It's your time to shine, Sarah. Code Shifter activate. Okay. Please, oh please, don't stop me for every, you know, every little bit. For God's sake, I can equip different skills on the menu. Okay, power up Sarah. Oh. Yo, if only game developing was this easy, you know what I'm saying? Anyways, man. You know, just a lot of people nowadays just expect too much. Oh my God. Can you throw the bug? I'm on it. But yeah, like, it's an alright platformer, man. I'm not reading this. I just want to play. I know what we have to do. Oh, Lord. I know what we have to do. The sound effects sound really nice, in my opinion. Oh my God, I know. Collect. You know, now... There we go. Nice. Okay. There we go. But yeah, so, you know, like I said before, man, the art style looks really nice. The walking animation looks really nice too. Bounce time? Oh, well, not boss time, but like, you know, just like a horde type thing going on here. Yeah, okay. But yeah, I don't think, you know, this game, you know, has some platforming segments of that, but I think it's more based on look at that. What's that doing here? Is the Kunoikan code colorful something because of the bug project data overflowing this area. Transformation items. Okay, so this is I can recover hero code from the gimmick button. Alright, type. How do I do that? Up? Oh, there it's B. That's tight. Yeah, okay. But yeah, so you know, I think a lot of people mistook in what this game is about, man. Ay ay ay. We can't double jump, but we could jump high. But yeah, I don't see anything wrong with this game, man. I really don't. Other than, look at that, new character. Yeah, because we're here for the story. I'll read the story in my own time. Oh. Oh, that's tight. Okay. Yeah, so, you know, I don't see anything wrong with this. It's a side-scrolling game. It's more like a visual novel. Oh, nice. I know this guy. He's from Guilty Gear, right? Pressing the assist button summon. Jesus! He jumps really high. All right. So we killed that character off. Dang it. It's fine though. We'll keep going. But yeah. I don't know, dude. I really don't know. Big nerd. Would it be cool to have like a game that would have like all these characters, just like sort of like Mega Man or Metroid, like the old school Metroid, right? Or, you know, Castlevania, you know, type thing where they could go around side scrolling, beating up things and stuff like that. Maybe, yeah, that would have been tight looking. But this, you gotta remember that this game is focused on the story, bro. Something is happening in this section of the studio that is, you know, bugging everything we do. We have a month to get rid of every bug. Or try to fix it, you know? What's all this about? This is Code Shifter, the debugging program I've been working on. I've named the avatar Sarah. You gave your software a nickname? Why not? She's my baby, after all. I can totally understand where she's coming from, bro. Baby? Okay, sure. What does she do? All the issues popping up with the team's data has me concerned, and I want to get to the bottom of it. So I made Sarah. She can analyze previous iterations of the code for changes and make revisions on the fly. That'll help us find the cause of most bugs. In fact, she's already discovered that this error is pretty similar to all the other cases. So you're saying it's not Moses' fault? That's exactly what I'm saying. See, I told you it wasn't me. Look, your code gives me trust issues. So sue me. Give him a little credit, Rudy. He doesn't do it on purpose. Thank you, Stella. You're so nice. Too nice. My point is, we can now use the code shifter to fix this bug for good. And she'll gain more skills as we collect data about using her. Okay. Great. Oops, sorry. I'll call you next time something comes up. Okay. But yeah, you see? It's all based around this story, man. I don't see anything wrong with this. It's a visual novel with a little bit of, you know, side-scrolling RPG stuff, bro. I don't, you know, wait a minute. Something's off. This is me correctly. Come on, Mosey, get your act together. My act is together. Thank you very much. It's that darn bug again. Here, see for yourself. Back me up on this one, Stella.
Sure thing, give me a second. Sorry, Mosey. I can't help you on this one.
You made a typo, you bigot. Whoops. Come on, man, pay attention. You should really be harder on him, Stella. She has a point, too. Attack, attack, attack. How did it get to be so late? This is a total time sink. Now that I made some progress with work, maybe I can fiddle with Sarah's settings for a... Oh my god. Wait, what? Mosey, what are you still doing here? You saw it for yourself, just how sloppy I can be. I've got to do better. But I can't fix this one part no matter how hard I try. I worked on it all day, too. Wow, look at you. You're turning a corner, Mosey. Well, I mean, I haven't yet. What's not working? Show me. Maybe I can give you a hand. Thanks, Celeste, right here. Okay, let me get it. Take a look at it. Weird. Mm-hmm. Mosey, I don't think it's not. This one's your fault. I think it's your favorite little bug. Things just got interesting. Give us a hand, sir. Okay, please don't sound so excited. Okay. Yes. Can we explore the? Oh my god! It's reminding me, Greg. Not to mention it, I don't refresh my here. Basic. Blah blah blah. Oh. First off, you can play our game, Colorful Fighters, in the game form. Okay. Okay. All right. Save data. Right. Thank you, Mosey. Okay. Let's see if I can switch my options here. No, I can't. Good to know. Okay. Well, wait a minute. How many options of the English, Japanese, Chinese, Korean, and English. All right, tight. All right. But yeah, I don't, like I said before, I don't see what's wrong with this, bro. By the way, I bought this game because of my number one favorite rule, judging a book by its freaking cover. And, you know, this game looked pretty tight. It looked pretty tight. Oh, gosh. Press start and see what's up. Stock. Okay. We already got a sense of how the... Alright, so... Oh, okay, so... I'll go with this guy because I know who he... I think he's from Guilty Gear. I'm not too entirely sure. What's this? Oh, it's just like... Oh, Lord! It's just like Smash Brothers! I'm getting jumped, dude! Can I just stay in a corner? Never mind. Dude, oh my. Just stay in the floor, dog. Oh, never mind. We're dead. Okay. I should have. Okay. Dang it. I'm dead. I'm just gonna let them kill each other. Yes. Get away from me! I'm gonna lose. Zero counts. Just leave me alone. Dude. Okay. Run away! Get away from me! A freaking course! Yeah, let's try, nerd. Oh! I'm guy lost. Bro, you have got to be kidding me. I thought it was going to be like a 1v1 and, you know, having three lives, right? But it wasn't. can't believe he won, bro. Dang it. Do I have a problem with that? Yes. Yes, I do have a problem with that. Because if I'm not mistaken, that's the guy from River City or whatever that game's called. You know, he's just a thug. He only has fists. We have the power of fire, and apparently the dude over there with the gray hair has the power to control darkness. How did he win? A mere mortal, dude. Anyway, so now you can play up to 4 players, which is pretty tight. All right. So I'm going to leave it off here before, you know, my Elgato decides to be a dingus. And, you know, I can't get out of here. Oh. So thank you guys for coming. I really do appreciate it. Subscribe, like, comment down below. Become part of Mr. Gaming 8. Mr. Gaming Gold Rated. Thank God when we're live, because if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be in the first place. Have faith in him, and have faith in him, because everything's going to be all right. Trust me. And everyone, please. Have a good afternoon. Good evening. And good night. Okay. Oh. You could also, you know, press the start button. Do that. Anyways. Code Shifter. It's a pretty tight game, man. Like I said before, it's a dang visual novel. You know what it is? It's just like Catherine, bro. It's just like Catherine. It's just like Punchline. It's just like Sakura Wars, which, you know, I really do want to get that game someday. But, you know, it's just like Sakura Wars. You know, it's like a visual novel, right? And it's sprinkled in with a little bit of, you know, fighting games and platformer games, 2D platformer games and pixel art, which is, I love pixel art, and this game has it all for me, right? I love the art style that they took for the main, like, you know, this right here, moving the main character, and the pixel art is amazing as well. Do I have a problem with it? The only problem I have with it is that I get interrupted while I am, you know, doing stuff, right? That's really a letdown to me, man. Oh my god. Oh geez, I don't like that. I really don't. You know, I'm moving along, going to the left or right, and all of a sudden I get stuck with the dialogue, bro. You know, I guess for me it comes from playing Castlevania, right? What is it? Castlevania 2? Dark Side, something Moon or Dark Side Moon, I can't remember. Where the little box text, the little text would like interrupt your thing, saying like, oh, you know, darkness falls and stuff like that. But, you know, that was tight. That was tight back then. It was all right. And I'm still liking it. But, you know, I kind of don't like it because it ruins the flow of the game for me. Now, is Code Shifter going to be for everybody? Bro, if you like visual novels and you like to read game, like stories in the game, and you don't mind, you know, the side scrolling bit, you know, that's, you'll be fine, you know. Is it worth 14 or what is it, 15 bucks? I'm not too sure, man. I don't know. I don't even know how long it is, bro. It's just like watch, I could tell you this right now. Me passing My Little Pony, a maritime adventure or whatever it's called, like the new My Little Pony game, and, you know, passing it and 100% in the game, I can tell you this right now that game is not worth the $40 they want, bro. I'm sorry, you know, you can say all you want, right? Like, it's not worth the $40, man. It's legit. Maximum to me, it's worth like $10, bro. It should be like a $10 game, man. I got it for $7. It was like somebody gave me like a discount on it, and I took it, right? I took it. But yes, that game, like the My Little Pony Maritime Adventure or whatever it's called, bro. Yeah, it's not worth the $40 that they ask, man. It's not even worth the money that it is when it's on sale, because I think when it's on sale, it's like 15 or like 13 bucks or whatever. That's not even worth it, dude. Oh my gosh, this game though, you know, if you're gonna be on the hate train, you know, by all means, it's your opinion. Well, actually, it's not your opinion, because you know, you guys are working as a collective hive mind and thinking alike, you know, hating on games. But it's for money. You guys can do whatever you want with it. And, you know, while I've been playing this game, yeah, you know, I'm going to try to 100% it. Not right now, because I'm trying to play other games, you know. For example, Saints Row. Saints Row, and I was gonna make a Kingdom Hearts the Chain by Memory or Memory Chain or whatever it's called video today, but I remember I have this game and I wanted to just get this game out of the way. But Chain of Memory, bro, I don't think it's not my favorite Kingdom Hearts game so far, bro. Because I don't know if I told you this, but I did play Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and no, I told my friend. I told my friend that I played Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and Rebirth. Never have I played like all of the other ones, right? And Chain of Memory comes along, and it uses a card system that I don't like. I really, really, I'm not going to lie, but it pisses me off. Like, it really does. Oh, Lord. The two times that I had to fight Riku, man, I just wanted to, you know. See you guys in the next one. Peace out, everybody. Stay with me. Stay safe. Go play some side-scrolling games, bro. Like I said, this is a visual novel game. A visual novel game sprinkled in with a little bit of other game. That's it. You know, the main course is a visual novel. You're reading the story of what's happening. You know, your favorite characters from all those other franchises are here just by coincidence, bro. I'm just saying, does it impact the story? Not really, bro. It's just cosmetics, man. I'm just saying. You know, if it's on sale, you know, I mean, yeah, for $2, it's fine. You know, what are you going to spend $2 on? Bag of chips, bro? You gotta cut down on those dudes, man. Haven't eaten a bag of chips in a while myself. But damn, son. $2 is $2, you know? You can't buy other games, you know, for $2. Especially, like, you know, this type of game for $2. Everything is, like, expensive. Especially the Nintendo Switch, bro? Damn, man. I'm seeing like the sell page and... Oh, before we leave, right? Before we leave, this is a rant. I'm seeing on the sales page, and everything that is on sale, right? Like the for example, the Star Wars games, right? Like the all the Xbox, like the original Xbox, like what is it, Command or something? I forgot. Dang it, I forgot it. Battlefield 1, 2, you know, KOTAR 1, 2, Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2. They're all on sale on the Switch, but damn, son, they're like $7, man. The hell's wrong with you guys, bro? Honestly, bro, what the hell's wrong with you? You know, you go to the Xbox, and they were having on the Lunar New Year sale, they were all for like $3, dude. I'm just saying, man, that's something else. All right, guys, that's it. Bit is up for reals, and I'll see you guys tomorrow with Nintendo Weekend.